Today we will continue learning Turkish language together. And today we will review everything what we learned already. So let's start. First of all, we learned Turkish alphabet and we know that there are 29 letters in Turkish language. And 8 of them are vowels, right? And after that, we learned that we can see them in two different groups. One is kalın ünlüler and another one is ince ünlüler. Hard vowels and soft vowels, right? Do you remember? Let's continue. And after that, we read a short text together. Let's read again. Merhaba, adınız nedir? Adım, sizin adınız nedir? Adım, nasılsınız? Teşekkür ederim, ben iyiyim. Siz nasılsınız? Teşekkür ederim, ben de iyiyim. Tanıştığımıza memnun oldum. Ben de tanıştığımıza memnun oldum. Görüşmek üzere. Hoşça kalın. Görüşürüz. Güle güle. Do you remember this text? And you know everything what it means, right? Because we studied already. Okay, let's continue. And after that, we learned what is this? How we can ask this question in Turkish and how we can answer. And right now we know that there are three words in Turkish. Bu, şu, o. This, that, it, right? And we know three questions. Ne, nasıl, kim? Ne, nasıl, kim? And the question could be, bu nedir? Şu nedir? O nedir? Remember? And the question could be like, bu ne? Bu nedir? Şu ne? Şu nedir? O ne? O nedir? And the answer can be, bu insan, şu insan, o ev, şu ev. İtaktale. You can change the words and you can make the sentences, right? And after that we learned bu kim, bu kimdir? Şu kim, şu kimdir? O kim, o kimdir? And kim means who, and therefore the answer is gonna be the person, right? So for example, bu Atatürk, şu Atatürk, o Atatürk, or bu Sabiha Gökçen, şu Sabiha Gökçen, o Sabiha Gökçen. Remember? Okay, let's continue. And after we learned hard vowels and soft vowels, we studied büyük ünlü uyumu. Büyük ünlü uyumu. And what we learned is that if the first syllable of the word has a hard vowel, then the other syllables have to have hard. If it's soft, then others are going to have soft. Do you remember that rule? Of course, there are exceptions, but it's a rule, you know. And according to that, we saw some examples, such as araba. The first vowel is a, it's kalın, and the others are a and a, so all of them are kalın, and the rule is working here, or the word Türkiye, Türkiye. The first vowel is ü, and it's ince, right, soft. And the others are i and e, so all of them are ince, soft. So the rule is working here too. So büyük ünlü uyumu here exists, right? Remember? And according to büyük ünlü uyumu, we learned how we can make the words plural. So first of all, to make them plural, we add lar or ler. But how we decide whether I need to add lar or ler, right? In that case, we are checking the last vowel. And if it's kalın, then we are using lar. If it's ince, then we are using ler. For example, araba, a, akşam, a, lokum, u. So therefore, we are adding lar. For example, ödev, e, vergi, i, defter, e. All of them are ince, and therefore we are adding ler. Remember? Let's continue. By the way, if you like my lessons, please subscribe my channel and make a comment if you have any questions and send a like. Teşekkür ederim. Let's continue. And after that, now we already know that there are 8 vowels in Turkish language and there are 2 groups, kalın and ince. But after that, we saw a little bit different things and we made 2 different groups too, right? And it will be like A, E, U, I, O, E, U, U. So düz ünlüler, yuvarlak ünlüler. And a, e, o, ö, ı, i, u, ü. So geniş ünlüler, excuse me, geniş ünlüler and dar ünlüler. Remember? So let's continue. So after that we studied küçük ünlü uyumu. First we studied büyük ünlü uyumu and then we studied küçük ünlü uyumu. So what it means? In büyük ünlü uyumu we are checking the first vowel and the whole word, right? But here we are checking syllable by syllable. First we are checking the first syllable and then we are looking at second. Then now our first syllable is second syllable and we are checking the third syllable. So syllables by syllable we are moving in küçük ünlü uyumu. Remember? So according to that, if the first syllable has a, e, ı, i, the next syllable has to have a, e, ı, i. Remember? For example, araba. The first one is a, so the others, not the others, the next one is gonna be a, e, ı, i. So next one is a, so the next one is gonna be a, e, ı, i. The rule is working like that. Remember, if you don't know, please check that video. I explained everything very well and long. And we learned that. For example, the word merhaba. Here, küçük ünlü uyumu. That rule is working. However, büyük ünlü uyumu is not working here. And if it's not büyük ünlü uyumu, in that case, we are not looking for küçük ünlü uyumu. Do you remember? And what else? We studied that if the first syllable has a o, ö, u, ü, in that case, the next syllable has to have a, e, u, ü. Remember? It's also küçük ünlü uyumu. Küçük ünlü uyumu. For example, öğrenci, the first vowel is ö, so the next vowel is gonna be a, e, u, ü. And the next vowel is e. Right now I'm checking only e. And because it's e, according to küçük ünlü uyumu, after e, there is gonna be a, e, ı, i, right? So there is e. So küçük ünlü uyumu is working here. Remember? And if you don't know, please check that video. I explained everything longer. So we are just trying to remember everything that we learned. Okay? Let's continue. So let's summarize. If the first syllable has a, e, ı, i, the next syllable is going to have a, e, ı, i. If the first syllable has o, ö, u, ü, the next syllable has to have a, e, u, ü. Remember? Continue. And according to that, we saw a table and we learned some exceptions such as alkol, otobüs, televizyon, Professor, these are the words that Turkish language received from other languages. So therefore, büyük ünlü uyumu, küçük ünlü uyumu, sometimes it's not working and we are not looking for that because these are not Turkish words. Yes, we are using these words in Turkish and they are in dictionary. However, the origin is not Turkish. Understand? And although there are some words like kavurma, yağmur, çamur, Yavuz, they are from another, I'm sorry. Although they are Turkish origin words, sometimes the rules are not working in some Turkish origin words either. So, don't consider like that. If the rule is not working, in that case, the word is not Turkish. No, it's not such a thing. However, it happens. And we learned that the letter vowel O never ever can be on second or third or fourth or fifth syllable. It has to be only on first syllable, right? If there is O in second or third or fourth or fifth syllable, it means that küçük ünlü uyumu is not working there. No need to check. Remember? Televizyon, yeah, it's Turkish word, but it's from another language and there is O at the end, nylon, limon, otobüs, O is on second or third or fifth. So küçük önlüğüm is not working. Let's move. And after we learned bu, şu, o and plural forms, then how we could say these, those, they. We learned about that and how we make them plural. Bunlar, şunlar, onlar. Do you remember? And how we made them? I explained everything there. Please watch that. Bunlar, şunlar, onlar. Okay? And the question could be similar. Bunlar ne? Şunlar ne? Onlar ne? İli bunlar nedir? Şunlar nedir? Onlar nedir? Or bunlar neler? Bunlar nelerdir? Şunlar neler? Şunlar nelerdir? Onlar neler? Onlar nelerdir? So there are four different variants that we can use. If you hear some of them, don't confuse and don't think that, oh, it's not right, it's not accurate, don't think like that. Bunlar ne? Bunlar nedir? Bunlar neler? Bunlar nelerdir? We use all of them in Turkish language. So get used to them, okay? And it's same for the question who? Kim? There can be four different variants that we can use, right? Remember? Let's continue. And the answer. Bunlar kitap, bunlar kitaplar. Şunlar öğretmen, şunlar öğretmenler. Onlar çalışan, onlar çalışanlar. There could be this kind of answer. So we don't have to say bunlar kitaplar. We can say bunlar kitap. We don't have to make the word plural because bunlar is already plural. And we understand that there are many of them. There is not only one. So when I say bunlar kitap, it means there are so many books. Bunlar kitaplar, again, it means there are so many books. I can understand that. Therefore, mostly we use like bunlar kitap. But sometimes you may hear or you may read bunlar kitaplar. Don't get confused, okay? And on next lesson, I hope we are going to start how we can say I, you, he, she, it in Turkish language and more. And then we are going to learn where is this? And then we are going to learn where are you from? Of course, we are going to ask some basic questions and we will try to answer them. And we will continue learning Turkish language together. Again, if you like my videos, please subscribe my channel and make a comment if you have any questions. Send a like. Teşekkür ederim. Thank you. Görüşmek üzere. See you later. Hoşça kalın. Hoşça kalın. It's not like goodbye, but it means like goodbye. But hoşça kalın. It means like we are gonna see each other again, I hope. It's not like we are never gonna see each other. Okay? So, hoşça kalın. Görüşmek üzere.